Hi there, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Despite being 3 weeks into spring, we woke up to snow and ice this morning. Plow trucks were out overnight, plowing and salting some areas. More than 100 schools delayed their starts because of the slick conditions out there. The man who admitted to helping Billy Flynn kill Greg Smart back in 1990 is set to go before the parole board today. Patrick Randall was 16 years old when he held a knife to Smart's throat as Flynn shot him in the head. Randall is now 41 years old and has been living at a halfway house. If he is granted parole, he could be released as soon as June 4th. Flynn was granted parole last month. A convicted sex offender from Walpole is now accused of climbing through a child's bedroom window in Hinsdale and sexually assaulting her. Donald Beattie faces charges of burglary and aggravated felonious sexual assault. Police say he entered the home this past weekend and that it appears Beattie's wife knows the alleged victim's family.
I can't go into a lot of details, but the charges do indicate that he entered a home. He was unauthorized to do so, and in the home, he sexually assaulted a 9-year-old girl.
Investigators say Beattie initially denied any involvement, but according to court records, he later told his wife he had done something wrong and couldn't go back to prison. He's being held on $500,000 cash bail. The Fisher Cats baseball team is scheduled to have their home opener tonight at 6:35 against New Britain, but there are questions if they can pull off the game after last night's snow. About an inch of crusty snow coated the stadium overnight. The infield is protected by a tarp. They're hoping the outfield will be melted by Mother Nature today, although it's not supposed to get all that warm today. We'll watch this situation throughout the day and keep you updated. We are just learning that the state police bomb squad was called to the state library in Concord this morning. Police say they did find a suspicious package there on the steps, but the good news is there was no threat and the scene was cleared shortly after. Investigators say embers from an outside maple sugaring operation are likely to blame for a fire in New London. When firefighters arrived on Stony Brook Road yesterday afternoon, they found flames in the garage spreading to the attached home. A short time later, there was a backdraft and smoke explosion in the attic of the home, which then caused a large part of the second floor ceiling to collapse onto firefighters below. Fortunately, no one was hurt. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.